Hello, and welcome to this overview of experimenting with mixtures, compounds, and elements. This is one of those fun units where students get to do a lot of chemistry. Therefore, safety is utmost importance in this unit. Please be sure you have reviewed all of the safety rules for chemistry when you're working with your students. And while we're on the subject of safety, I want to point out your safety data sheets. There have been some changes to the chemicals that we use in this unit. We have replaced the lead nitrate and the sodium iodide, which were used in inquiry one, and they've been replaced with magnesium sulfate and sodium carbonate. Also, we have added an engineering activity that uses sodium polyacrylate and a few other things that were already included in your unit or your module, so you already have those safety data sheets. Those are important changes in the chemicals that you need to be aware of. And as always, these safety data sheets should be at hand whenever you're using any of these chemicals. So please print these and go over them. Be sure you always know exactly where they are and that they are in the room with you when you are using these chemicals. All right, that said, let's take a look at all of the performance expectations that this module drives students toward mastering. It's a good many. Remember, you can pause the video if you need to take a few minutes to read these more carefully. Notice the asterisk, which indicates an engineering activity, and we have added a whole activity to meet that standard or to drive students toward meeting that standard, which is the terminology that we say now because you really can't meet a standard in one lesson anymore. Also notice that this unit incorporates a GLOBE lesson. You should be familiar with GLOBE, and you will need to contact your specialist to do a face-to-face GLOBE training so that you can be officially certified for this GLOBE protocol and to enter your data onto the GLOBE website so that you too can be a part of a community of scientists. Other changes in this module include lots and lots of wording, as we've done with all of our modules that were written before the Next Generation Science Standards, where we incorporate questions and things that drive toward the scientific and engineering practices, the cross-cutting concepts, and the disciplinary core ideas that are included in our three-dimensional standards or performance expectations. So please pay attention to the wording in the PowerPoints, especially in the notes, as you go through this unit, and have a wonderful time. Thanks for watching.